For just $10 billion, you can become one of the first space tourists to visit Mars. At least, according to the famous American entrepreneur Elon Musk, that's how much it will cost to get one of the first tickets to the Red Planet with his company SpaceX. Musk is already planning the first flight in 2022. But for the average person, there aren't too many sightseeing tours to Mars. Mankind wants to colonize Mars due more to necessity than just fascination. According to Elon Musk, Mars is the only refuge that can save the human species from extinction in an event such as World War III. According to the entrepreneur, this extinction event may happen in the coming decades. But when exactly? 2026? 2037? Or maybe the year 2058? If Elon is right, then it may soon be time to pack your bags. But can scientists, by relatively near 2058, make possible not only a flight to Mars, but also the ability for humans to exist on this lifeless planet? On Mars, we expect to make many incredible discoveries, and there will be new opportunities that aren't possible on Earth. One of them is the creation of a truly uncensored and secure internet. Indeed, on Earth, it's not the first time we've seen infringement on freedom of speech, and nearly any country can ban or block whatever content it chooses to. In addition, it's often difficult to protect your personal data from compromise. So far, we haven't reached Mars, but Earthlings have a simpler and more convenient way to get unrestricted internet: NordVPN. Thanks to thousands of servers located in more than 61 countries, with NordVPN, you can access almost any content, including in China, where even YouTube is blocked. Get all this at an incredible 75% discount for 3 years. In other words, you only pay $2.99 a month for 36 months, much cheaper than a flight to Mars. Moreover, NordVPN works on iOS, Windows, Linux, and more, and one account covers up to 6 devices. Using the NordVPN mobile application, you can safely scroll the newsfeed on your smartphone without fear that someone will hack into your online payment accounts. So follow the link in the description, use the promo code RIDDLE, and get an extra month of NordVPN for free. That's nordvpn.com/RIDDLE. So let's turn back to Mars. The company Mars One aimed to exceed the promises of Musk's SpaceX in the race for space tourism. In 2012, they announced an ambitious plan for the development of the Red Planet. By 2026, Mars One plans to send residential blocks, life support systems, satellites, solar panels, and scientific equipment to Mars. They announced an open competition for the positions to be among the first colonists on Mars. The training program for this trip was supposed to be 10 years long. But despite this, more than 200,000 people from all over the world applied for positions. Would you be willing to leave the Earth forever for the sake of conquering a new, unexplored planet? Write in the comments. Still, even if you wanted to fly away from your earthly problems, the possibility of moving to a Martian city established by Mars One now seems unlikely. Unfortunately, in January 2019, the project was closed due to a lack of funding. But this unfortunate setback didn't discourage scientists. Space agencies around the world are working every day on projects that should make a manned flight to Mars possible. But what exactly is waiting for us on the Red Planet when we finally land there? First of all, there will be incredible, albeit desert, landscapes. So if you find yourself among the first colonists, you'll enjoy a stunningly blue sunset over the Red Planet. You'll also have the opportunity to visit Olympus Mons, the largest volcano in our solar system, almost 3 times as high as Mount Everest, 14 miles or 22 kilometers. Just don't forget to bring your favorite sweater. After all, the cold climate on Mars is simply unbearable, with an average temperature of minus 56 degrees Celsius. That's minus 69 degrees Fahrenheit. At the equator, of course, it's warmer, at about 35 degrees Celsius or 95 degrees Fahrenheit, but only during the day. At night, even at the equator, the temperature drops to minus 73 degrees Celsius. That's minus 99 degrees Fahrenheit. So hold on just a second. Maybe mankind should colonize someplace warmer. But no, scientists insist on the red planet. According to their forecasts, after Terra formation, Mars will become an ideal home for humans. There's certainly a basis for such optimistic forecasts. Mars has everything we need to support life. There's water and nitrogen, as well as carbon and oxygen in the form of carbon dioxide. The problem is that the ratio of these elements is not ideal. Carbon dioxide is 95.3%, nitrogen 2.7%, and oxygen only 0.2%. But if we find a way to turn carbon dioxide into breathable air and create the conditions for life, we'll be much closer to realizing the colonization of Mars. At the time this video was created, scientists had developed as many as three ways of terraforming the red planet. The first method is to install orbital mirrors with a diameter of at least 250 kilometers or 155 miles. These lenses are expected to reflect sunlight, effectively melting the ice at the Martian poles. Carbon dioxide will be released from the glaciers, and this will lead to greenhouse gas emissions and an increase in temperature. The problem is that these giant mirrors will weigh at least 200,000 tons, and getting them to Mars will be a huge challenge. So scientists are trying to identify the necessary raw materials in space. The second method involves the construction of factories for the production of greenhouse gases. These factories will need to imitate photosynthesis, absorb carbon dioxide, and release oxygen, gradually making the air suitable for breathing. Greenhouse factories will have to operate on solar energy, of course, if at all, since it's still impossible to transport heavy power plants to Mars. Building them on the red planet seems an obstacle as well. But it appears that scientists from Northwestern University in Chicago have discovered a solution. They acquired the Martian dust imitators at NASA, using them as 3D printing material, and obtained elements that work well together. So, can we just bring a 3D printer to Mars and print all the necessary parts for the greenhouse plants once we arrive? The answer to this question is we do not yet know. But even if the plans for building factories don't work, people have a third method of terraforming Mars. Space scientists Christopher McKay and Robert Zubrin, authors of The Case of Mars, want to use artificial ice asteroids with ammonia. According to their plan, nuclear thermal rocket engines need to somehow be attached to real asteroids. The rockets will guide the asteroids and force them, albeit very slowly, to move towards Mars. When the asteroids collide with the red planet, about 130 million megawatts of energy will be released. This will increase the temperature by 3 degrees Celsius or 5.4 degrees Fahrenheit. And due to the melting of glaciers, about a trillion tons of water will be released onto the planet. Over the course of 50 years, several missions like this one will create a temperate climate on Mars and cover up to 25% of the planet's surface with water. Do you think this approach will work? And if so, how exactly will the red planet change after all these incredible human efforts? To answer this question, scientists have applied an algorithm used in determining the climatic zones of the Earth to Mars. They took the topographic data on Mars from NASA as a basis and obtained a possible climate map of the planet. If we can believe the results, after terraforming on Mars, you'll be able to enjoy a vacation on the red planet like you would in Nice, France. For example, today the province of Elysium is a group of extinct volcanoes. But after terraformation, the area should become a real beach resort. Margaritifer Terra, or Pearl Land, is characterized by a large number of craters and undercurrents. But after artificial climate change, Margaritifer may become a true paradise with a climate similar to that of the Mediterranean. The district of Coloritas, which is now a deserted tectonic rift, will be covered in snow and it'll be a wonderful destination for skiers. For those who may want to consider Mars as a permanent place of residence, scientists recommend to pay attention to what may become the two most densely populated areas in the future, which today is known as a huge channel of a dry riverbed, and West Noakes, which is of interest to scientists because of its dunes and drainage channels. Yeah, it seems that people have thought through all the technical aspects of the colonization of Mars. But the most unpredictable still remains: human behavior. How will people interact with each other, and what will be a fair way to divide up such an attractive area? Fortunately, the same questions were also asked in the British Interplanetary Society in London. There, people are already working on the future constitution of the Red Planet and a set of rules to govern the behavior of future colonists. According to futurologists and scientists, at first, all people on Mars will live in one community. But over time, conflicts may arise. Someone will definitely create a rebellion or revolution, and there probably will be warring tribes. Such situations can be avoided if dictatorial regimes are prevented and legal, non-violent means of opposing the government are developed. For example, the creation of trade unions like on Earth. Although, you see, laws do not always help us resolve conflicts. What do you think? Will people on Mars be able to start a new life and avoid repeating the sad pages of the history of our Earth? If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. Also, don't forget to click on the bell to enable notifications about the release of new videos. And stay with us. There's still a lot more interesting videos ahead. And don't forget to recommend us to your friends. Science is more fun together.